Yes, I am Winona Helder. I am Executive Director of Food and Water Watch. We're an organization in Washington, D.C. We have 10 offices. We have a small international program and are mostly focused on policy in the U.S.
How did you get involved with the Elevate?
You know, I think that I was invited because I'm going to be attending conference in Berlin on the Global Commons, and we work on water issues and water privatization and commodification of water. We have a campaign in the US to stop municipal water services from being privatized, and also focused on companies like Nestle that are doing water mining for bottled water.
Austria is a country which has so much water. Do you think it is a good idea to share this water to water-poor countries?
I think that water belongs to the ecosystem that it springs from, and so large water transfers aren't a good, they're not an ecologically sustainable thing to do, and we have to learn to live within our water resources.
One of the festival's topics is Elevate the Movements. Which movement is important to you?
Well, you know, we work on food and water related issues, which are part of a progressive movement in the US. I suppose they are, in some cases, a different movement, but they're also very integrated. And the idea is to use the resources that we have and to produce food in the most sustainable way possible. And that means that we sometimes focus on federal legislation that is really controlled by corporate interests that are producing food for profit rather than for people.
What is the most important change we have to do?
Well, I think that what we have to do is organize to hold our political leaders accountable for their policies. And so in the US, we have a big job. It's very difficult to hold our elected leaders accountable for what they're doing. And so we have to organize in all of the areas where people are currently voting against their self-interest. And because of the way that our political system is organized, every state in the US has two senators, even though some states, like say Wyoming, has a smaller population than Washington, D.C., which actually has no senators because we don't have federal representation. So we have to figure out how to organize in those areas where that aren't very urban and where there are a lot of different cultural and sociological differences from the urban coastal areas. And that's one of the reasons that we're working on food issues, because we actually need rural areas to have agricultural production. We just don't want it to be for crops that really aren't helping people and that are really keeping us from getting to a sustainable food system, and that don't allow the farmers there to actually make a good living, because all of the profits are sucked out to go to agribusiness, the factory farms that grow animals, and the processed food companies. And so those are some of the changes that we're working on.